Hello students, welcome to an academy. I'm Krishna Varma, your educator, and this is the third lecture of detonation. So in this lesson I'm going to discuss about theories of detonation. There are basically two types of theory, auto ignition theory and detonation theory, as well as I will discuss how to detect detonation in spark ignition engine. So let's start our lesson. These are the contents of today's lesson. First, I will discuss how to detect detonation. Then I will discuss theories of detonation. I will cover these two topics in today's lesson. This diagram is representing the working of spark ignition engine during the abnormal combustion. See here, you can see our auto ignition. Auto ignition, the main cause of auto ignition is self ignition temperature. When the temperature of the charge cross the limit of self ignition temperature, so there is some abnormal combustion takes place into the combustion chamber, that is called auto ignition. So this auto ignition is the main cause of detonation. So let's start our lesson with the how to detect detonation. Here, as you know, the detonation is the abnormal combustion and it affect the performance of engine. So if we detect the detonation into the engine or during the working of the SI engine or spark ignition engine, we can easily control it. If we want to control the detonation, we can easily control the detonation, and we can control the detonation by these these are some point which are helpful to detect the detonation. By these way we can detect the detonation easily and we can take some corrective action to control the detonation. So let's start. The first point is when the engine noise is too high. So this is the easiest way to detect detonation. If we are getting some abnormal noise or high intensity noise from the engine, so that means there are some chances of detonation into the engine. So this is the first way by which we can detect detonation. Second one is knock meter to measure vibration. Generally, as we know, there are some vibration setups into the cylinder, and this is the because of that vibration that detonation happened into the combustion chamber or into the cylinder. So this vibration setup by the detonation can be measured by the knock meter. We can measure the vibration with the help of knock meter, and this if we are measuring or we are measuring the vibrations from the knock meter, so this knock meter is having a vibration sensitive electric pickup also, so we can measure the vibration with the help of knock meter. Next one is the thermocouple to measure the temperature. As we know, the temperature is the main cause of detonation, or we can say the high temperature is the main cause of the detonation. So this high temperature can be measured by this thermocouple. This thermocouple is helpful to measure the temperature into the cylinder, and this high temperature, if we are getting high temperature in the thermocouple, it indicate knocking or detonation. So this is another way by which we can detect detonation. Next one is if excessive smoke coming from the exhaust, or if the excessive smoke is present in the exhaust, it indicate detonation. So this is the fourth way by which we can detect detonation. So these are the points by which we can detect detonation and we can take corrective actions to control the detonation. Now I will discuss second point, theories of detonation. So basically there are two types or two general theories of knocking or detonation. First one is auto ignition theory and second one is detonation theory. I will discuss one by one the auto ignition and detonation theory both. Here this auto ignition theory is based on the auto ignition or self ignition temperature. So let's start with the auto ignition theory. Now, as you know about the detonation, I already discussed or I already explained in the previous lecture. So this auto ignition, here I will discuss about first what is auto ignition. I'll give you a small introduction of auto ignition. Auto ignition means the combustion when the combustion start into the spark ignition engine without any external means or flame, and this combustion start only because of self ignition temperature, that is called auto ignition. And during this auto ignition, or because of that auto ignition, there is a increase in temperature and pressure we generally consider inside the cylinder, which cause vibrations, and these vibration cause detonation. Now, as I already told you that the auto ignition or ignition does not start immediately when the fuel reaches its self ignition temperature. In that condition, there are some ignition delay period takes place at that particular time. That ignition delay period, because of that self ignition temperature, that ignition delay takes place. Now, suppose when the fuel enters into the suction stroke or intake stroke during the working, and that time after that, that fuel will compress during the compression stroke, and during the compression stroke, as we know, the temperature and pressure of the charge increase. So as per this graph, you can see a graph here. So as per this graph is between the temperature and time. You can see the vertical side is temperature and the horizontal side is time, which this graph is representing the self ignition temperature and the ignition delay for the charge. This is representing the relationship between the self ignition temperature and ignition delay for the graph. So when the temperature after compression, if we are considering when the charge compressed during the compression stroke at that particular time, or you can see here in this particular graph, this AB, this curve AB is representing the compression compressing during the compression stroke. So at that point the temperature is continuously increasing. So during compression stroke the temperature of the charge will continuously increase. And if we are considering the temperature after compression or after compression stroke is below the self ignition temperature, and it is represented by point B here, this dashed line is representing the self ignition temperature. So at point B, you can see the temperature after compression is less than the self ignition temperature. So at that point, the charge will not ignite. That charge will not auto ignite. Some external means we require to ignite the charge. And at that particular time at point B, the charge will start cooling very slowly. And here you can see this point or this curve BC or this line BC is representing the ignition delay, when the ignition is not happening and the charge will start cooling very slowly. So this ABC is the graph is representing when the charge is not getting its self ignition temperature. Now if we are considering when the charge is getting the self ignition temperature limit after compression stroke, if we are considering after compression stroke the temperature of the charge reach the auto ignition limit, as you can see here in this graph A, B dash and C dash, this A, B dash is representing the graph when the charge is reaching the self ignition temperature limit. So at that particular time the charge will auto ignite with some ignition delay. Here we also consider some ignition delay, but this ignition delay is represented here as B dash C dash, but it is less than BC. So we can say here at that point there are some ignition delay also considerable, and this is because of some chemical reaction from or during BC dash which helps to ignite the charge. This chemical reaction helps to ignite the charge, and here we will consider. So at this BC, AB dash C dash is representing the process with self ignition temperature, and if we continuously increase the temperature of the charge, the ignition delay will be shorter. Here you can see in this graph, if we are continuously increasing the temperature of the charge, it is decreasing the ignition delay. So this is representing the this graph is representing the relationship between the self ignition temperature and ignition delay for the charge. And one more point, this auto ignition takes place when the energy released by the reaction, and this auto ignition also takes place because of the presence of chemical. So this is the cause of auto ignition. Now this was all about the auto ignition theory. Next I will discuss the detonation theory. As I already explained in auto ignition, that auto ignition theory, in auto ignition theory we generally consider the pre-flame reaction. The pre-flame reaction and the self-ignition temperature is the main cause of detonation. But in detonation theory, we generally consider mainly because of the auto-ignition, there are some detonation or there are some pressure waves forms, and these pressure waves can form because of high temperature and pressure and because of the auto-ignition, and these pressure waves would travel into the combustion chamber, and because of this pressure wave it compress the gases and it create vibrations into the cylinder, and these vibrations into the cylinder is the actual cause of detonation. This cause detonation. So this is the detonation theory, where we consider the pre-flame reaction in self-ignition temperature. We consider the pre-flame reaction in self-ignition temperature during the auto-ignition. Then auto-ignition we also consider during the detonation theory, as well as we consider the pressure waves into the detonation theory, which create vibrations, and this vibration create some disturbing sound like hammer, and like hammer blow, and this hammer blow sound, if we are getting from the engine, this cause detonation. It means we are getting some detonation into the work during the working of SI engine. But here it is doubtful that the detonation takes place either because of the normal flame velocity at combustible mixture or by the short length of the flame. We cannot predict, we cannot detect what is the exact reason of detonation. So this was all about the theory of detonation, auto ignition theory and the detonation theory. Thank you so much, and please subscribe the channel for more lectures.